Hi, I am Stephen Cho from Juga Kung Fu, Penang, Malaysia. Juga is a short bridge Kung Fu system and it uses Phoenix Eye Fist as its primary weapon. The advantage of Phoenix Eye Fist over the ordinary flat fist is the amount of pressure generated by the Phoenix Eye Fist. According to the Pascal theory, pressure equals to force over area. It means that with the same amount of force, if the area of the contact is smaller, the pressure will be greater. Phoenix Eye Fist has about 20 times smaller area compared to the flat fist. You can see the flat fist area is bigger and the Phoenix Eye Fist area of contact is smaller. It can produce 20 times more pressure compared to the flat fist if the amount of the force applied is the same. Hence, we can conclude that the Phoenix Eye Fist can produce very huge impact if you compare to the flat fist. This is how we form a Phoenix Eye Fist. So make sure that this part is tightly closed together to have a solid structure. So this is wrong. This is correct. Okay? You need to close it tightly like this. If it is not tightly closed, then you may have a risk of injuring your finger due to poor structure of your Phoenix Eye Fist formation. Now, I would like to show how we execute a Phoenix Eye Fist in our Juga system. So this is how we do it. Okay, place both hands at the center line. See. Twist, then kneel down. Twist, then kneel down. Twist. Then kneel down, twist, then kneel down, twist, then kneel down. Okay, from the side view, twist, kneel down, twist, kneel down, twist, kneel down, twist, kneel down. Okay, make sure you kneel down at the end of the punch, twist and kneel down. Please take note that we need to make sure the punch travel along the center line. We don't do something like this. This is wrong. This is wrong. Because the punch does not travel along the center line. This is the correct one. And also we need to sink our elbow while punching and with about 80% extension of the arm. We don't fully extend the arm, okay? It is about 80% of the arm extension. So please remember that sinking elbow is very important in Juga system. So without a sinking elbow, then there is no Juga. The Phoenix Eye Fist punch of our Juga system does not look like long fist. So this is long fist, long fist. See this, the elbow is pointing to the side and the arm is fully extended. So this is long bridge, long bridge, long bridge. Okay, Juga is a short bridge kung fu, but not a long bridge kung fu. So when we do Juga, punch So we need to do it with the short bridge method. This is the short bridge. The striking to the air alone will not help us to condition the Phoenix eye fist. So let me show you the two ways that we usually do condition the Phoenix eye fist. So this is the Phoenix eye fist striking pads. It consists of 5 pads. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Each pad is with 5 cm diameter, or you can use a bigger pad if you are a beginner. In Cantonese, we call this as a choi ba. As I mentioned just now, we have two ways in the training the accuracy and condition the Phoenix eye fist. So the first method is mainly used to train the accuracy of the Phoenix eye fist and toughening it by training with this pads choi ba. Let me show you all how I do it. You can design your own combination, it doesn't matter. So let me show you a few combinations so that you can follow this method to train. Combination 1. Combination 2. Combination 3. The second method of training is to strengthen the Phoenix eye fist. So we need to lean forward and push the Phoenix eye fist to the wall through the pads and twist it. Lean forward, twist it, twist it, twist it. So this will train the strength and the structure of the Phoenix eye fist. Lean forward, make sure you lean forward.